those fingers in my hair, that sly come hither stare.
XK 150.
That was an interesting story.
Perhaps so, if we walk in.
Yeah.
Sure.
Sight unseen. Just online.
How long
bought,
have you...
Bought online.
How long have you owned it?
2 years now.
2 years. Right, okay.
Bought it sight unseen online, went over to Sydney to pick it up. Picked it up on a Wednesday afternoon. First time I drove it was out of North Sydney across the Harbour Bridge into Darling Harbour area.
Nice.
Just to stay the night. And then the next morning started driving back to Perth.
Right, okay. Oh, so you drove...
All the way back to Perth. In a sight
on your second trip on the road.
Yep, hottest time on the road. Weather ever.
I'm assuming it doesn't have air conditioning.
No.
It does now, but it didn't then.
Yeah, it didn't.
Right, okay.
43 degrees through Balladonia, and it travelled cooler when you're doing 10 kilometres per hour over the speed limit than when you're doing the speed limit.
That's really interesting that your second trip was across the Nullarbor.
Second day in the car.
Jaguars did have... question mark over reliability in the 60s. How did the trip go?
Interestingly, let's just reverse back a little bit. Graham asked friends who do own one, how will the car go if I drive it across the Nullarbor?
And about five of my friends who have these cars all said, no problems at all.
Really?
Then I drove it back, and when I got it here, they said, we thought you were kidding.
ours couldn't have done it. So yeah, thanks a lot, guys.
It was using about half a pint of oil every 500 miles, which is what they do, and just kept on top of the water in the radiator.
Nothing went
wrong with it.
And how was it? Did you enjoy
it?
Was it an enjoyable experience?
Very enjoyable trip.
Yeah?
Stopped to do the oyster run through Smoky Bay and Streaky Bay. And
how long did it take you?
Dawdle took 4 days.
4 days? Oh, that's not too much of a dawdle, though. Yeah.
But we had to have the oyster run.
Yeah, of course. That's 1,000 k's a day.
That was 1,000 k's a day.
So I'm at home thinking, well, I'm not that fussed on this car. You know, I'd seen it online. And when he got home, it was, oh, whoa.
So it was in the flesh.
He is beautiful.
Wow. And why he? You say he.
Well, he just looks so masculine. And if you had have heard the car when Graham first bought it, it had a really harsh... exhaust, so it couldn't be anything soft.
Right. It wasn't purring.
He became Jimmy, and he was just awesome. So
the fact that you're saying it's sort of very muscular,
very masculine looking.
You're basing that on Graham.
Oh, absolutely. You know,
so it's a compliment.
This is my example.
So you doubled the clutch then?
Yeah,
you did.
You don't need to do so much going to second to third or fourth.
Yeah, but definitely first and second, yeah. And do you give it a little rev in between?
Sometimes give it a blip, yeah.
Yeah, just a blip.
Graham's going to let me drive his beautiful Jaguar XK 150. This really is a dream come true for me. When I was about 16, my dad took me to a car show, and one of the cars I saw there was this car, and I just thought it was the most beautiful thing I'd ever seen. So it's the first time I'm going to have a drive. Being an old car, it's a bit tricky. I'm going to have to double the clutch. There's a few idiosyncrasies associated with driving it. It's got a carbon clutch, so I'm going to have to make sure I don't keep the clutch depressed. Otherwise, I'll burn the clutch out. So here we go. On the drive over, how did people respond when you were driving around, when you pulled up to service stations?
Everywhere, people just taking photographs of it, talking about the car. There was an RBT who got pulled up at. The person I had driving with me, it was his day to take a break, so he could do the wineries he wanted to do, and I drove that day, and just as he was telling me very slurringly that he's fine enough to drive now, I said, no, you're not, and there's an RBT up ahead. Pulled into the RBT, I blew zero, and we were stuck there for half an hour because the
people
policeman
admiring.
The policeman did the breath test. His father always wanted one of these.
Oh,
so
right,
had the bonnet open. It was like we're being inspected for drugs or whatever.
Yeah,
he
sure.
He went through the car just to have a look at it.
Right, it's actually a push start, believe it or not. 1958, push start. That's technology. Okay, I'm actually quite nervous. Right. Yeah, here we go, four gears. Gonna have to double the clutch, haven't doubled the clutch since I drove.
brakes like?
The brakes are good. They're four-wheel disc brakes.
Yeah. Now, was this the first car with disc brakes? Yeah.
First car with four-wheel discs. The XK140 had drums.
You've mentioned the masculinity and the muscularity of the car and the noise.
All of the above.
Graham, for you, what?
It's just
what driving. Are the things that stand out for you?
The driving of it. It's a very well advanced car for its time. It's got torsion bar suspension up front. It's independent. It's got four-wheel disc brakes. It's just a very advanced car in its day.
Yeah.
It's,
as long as he doesn't stall, he'll be right.
I think there's a good chance he will stall.
There we go.
No. Prove me wrong. Thank you.
Well done.
Never doubted you for a second, Matt.
I won't say a word. Not a word.
If you're listening, Matt, you're an excellent driver.
Oh, look, she's not an easy car to drive. He is not an easy car to drive.
Right.
That would be the hardest car in all of our cars.
Yes.
So,
there's not many people around who've experienced having to double the clutch.
No.
Now, that's pretty unique now.
Yeah.
Right. So, the thing I like about this one is you look at the badge.
Ah, it creates the timeline.
Only 51, so one of them on 51, 53, 55, 56, 57, this one's 58.
This is a 58, right, okay. So basically it's built, this is the culmination of that success.
Basically, yes.
Yeah.
It's a driver's car. He's a driver. He loves the drive. The car is almost superfluous. It just happens to be a driver's car and it's beautiful.
Yeah.
In their day were the ultimate sports car, weren't they?
Absolutely.
The ultimate road-going sports car.
And based on their racing history, they were just phenomenal.
Yeah. Well, like you say, they're pretty much consecutive years at Le Mans.
Reason we have two cars every time we come here is two cats come down with Graham and two dogs come with me. And people look, and you put dogs in your car. Yeah, we do. Mm. You put cats in your car. Yeah, we just have to put covers on the leather because one of the cats tends to grip
the leather. If there was an equivalent of RSPCA for cars, I'd be calling them right now.
Oh, no, one cat sits on the back shelf. He loves it.
Yeah. The other one has to go.
I'm sure they do.
He gets more looks than the car sometimes because he puts his head up and looks around.
Wow. It's strange. I've never driven a car with such a long bonnet.
Oh, wait till you drive this one next time.
Wow, yeah, but an old car with a long bonnet. All right, indicator's this one?
Yep.
Yeah, do everything right. I'm just going to take it real easy, bro. Oh, shit.
It's fairly responsive.
Yeah, I can imagine. Oh, shit. Didn't really do that smoothly. Not impressing you with my skills.
It's a must box. Takes a while.
It does feel really strange not having a seatbelt on. It's amazing how you get so used to wearing a seatbelt.
It's sort of a comfort zone. That's why it's got a grab handle here, which is completely useless, but sort of concession to panicking passengers.
So, Lisa, you were saying you love the shape.
That shape is just absolutely gorgeous. You know, see that coming to you is just so beautiful.
Sometimes you're a pedestrian on the crossing.
As we were saying earlier, when I was a teenager and I first saw these cars, that was exactly, it was that shape. Classic and beautiful, but not scared to be, here I am.
Yeah,
you know, because it is a very, you know, statement sort of piece.
But you know what I love about these old cars as well, is the chrome. Cars, they miss the chrome.
They do.
There's I don't know, it's just a beauty. You know, different shapes.
It's not
shapes.
Over the top like some of the American
cars. No, this is tasteful. You know, the lines of it just allow the air to go over or get captured in the grill.
Yes, indeed, in me. Proceed with what you're leading me to. It's such an ancient pitch, but one I wouldn't switch. 'Cause there's no nicer witch than you.